Okay, so I just got through doing the epoxy resin on this one here, and I'm going to attempt to hold it up. Let's see if I can get it away from that light just a little bit. It's got some really cool stuff going on there. This metallic paint is really showing through. But it does have some areas like right here by my name. Come on, focus. So you can tell right there where it's light a little bit. And then over there by the light, there's a spot. You can tell there's a few spots like right there where it's kind of beating up. So that means that I'll have another coat to do on it, but that's okay. This is like my first time doing this, so I'm learning. I'll have to clean it really well and then do it again. Okay, here I go. I'm going to pour some epoxy as soon as I get my microphone on. This is my first pour ever, so, and these are some of my like favorite paintings, so I hope this works. And I'm pouring it over gloss. I had already glossed those, so I'm hoping this works okay. Where's my dealie at here? Okay, so I have a little dealie to level it. It looks like I got plenty on there. Kind of fun. I've never tried this before. Just got to make sure you push everything up there, I guess. It's not that hard. This is a little printer package thing. I thought it would be good because it's plastic and whatnot. The corners do seem to be a bit tricky. I'm just afraid. I don't want to screw anything up, you know. I'm going to go ahead and do that just to make sure I don't get too much on the corners and then it have a build up. I hope this is all right with all this on here. Okay, well, I'm going to take a look at it. In the light, looks like I might see one bubble, maybe two. Okay, maybe three. Other than that, it looks really good. Dude, if it looks that good when it dries, I'll be like super pumped. Dude, I know I talk like a surfer sometimes, and then sometimes I talk like a hick. So they said you're supposed to hit it with a heat gun just to work out the bubbles. Some lady even microwaved her resin before she started. And she said that that helped kind of loosen it up a little bit. Boy, over here it looks just ever so lightly thin. And maybe that was just a bubble happening. I'm not even sure what bubbles look like. This stuff seems pretty cool. Like, it's pretty easy to work with. It's real flowy, like, if that's a word. I can see tiny, tiny little bubbles pop up. Especially right in there is, looks like a lack of material. Let's get on it. What the heck? Oh, that's because I glossed it. That's what's happening. It's bubbling because I glossed it. Uh-oh. Well, shoot. Well, they said that this stuff doesn't like when you use silicone in your paint, and they said that the silicone bubbles up through there, so that is what's happening. But I guess I gloss coated it, so it probably needs a matte finish instead of a well, the bubbles won't go away, so that's a learning lesson right there. They all just keep coming back. That's okay. This is my first one, so I've been pretty happy about it so far. I'm gonna let that one dry, and then if I need to put another one on top of that, I'll use some type of cleaner to get in there and dull that down, maybe even a little sandpaper or something. Okay, the colors, it really makes your colors like stand out amazing. So okay, just poured the resin coat on this one here, and it appears to be doing really well. I don't really see any, like, where the silicone I used, where it's bubbling up or anything like that. So now they say hit it with the heat gun to get the bubbles out. This is like one of my favorite pieces of art, so I really didn't want to mess it up. But if I do, I do. I'm totally chill. I mean, you can always make more art, right? Okay, just finished this piece. I have to hurry because I still have another piece to do. But I just poured the epoxy on it. You can tell how glossy it is. But I'm loving the looks of it there. So I gotta set this one aside. But anyways, that's it for that one. Now on to the next. I am going to be doing a resin cast for the first time. So I saw online that you can take some painter's tape and put it around there, the edges, just like that. And you can tell I've already signed it. I was actually already done with this one. You can tell it has a glossy coat on it. So I hope the resin takes. I'm a little unsure about it, but we'll see, you know. So I have this Envirotex Light pour on finish. I'm going to be taking some cups and stuff and mixing it up, and we'll see how it goes. I'll splice a couple of videos together here for you. I poured the resin on here for you. Gosh, I wish you could see the reflection better. There it is. It is like super cool. It really brings out the colors. Like here. But you could tell how glossy it is. It's super thick. Anyways, I thought you might like to see that. I'm gonna do those two next over there,